Like the Crosby in your honor, will you please rise and pledge allegiance?
Sure.
Pledge allegiance to the flag.
And I take this paragraph as a republic for which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Munson?
Andrew Benson, here. Katrina Minkowitz.
Here.
Jeff Day.
Here.
Joseph Buckmore.
Here.
Edward Levine.
Here. Item four on our docket is Lansing Community Library Report, which is in your packets. Number five is the Lansing Youth Service Report, which is also in your packet. Bring us to item six, which is the county, Tompkins County Legislature Report, Mike Sibber. Hi, Mike.
Hey.
Good.
I'm trying to quit. Because I only have one meeting to report on. Hello, thank you for having me again. I want to thank Kay Marshall Lynch, our public reporter for the county, and Joel Liberty from her reports. Tompkins County Administrator Jason Lehman, he has delivered the county legislature's 2019 recommended county budget. We are right now in extended budget meetings over here from every different department about what they're planning to do. Those are the overcharge requests and things like that. So we're hearing about those, and a lot of those have been approved. Looks like the tax rate is going to go down, and the tax rate will go up just a bit, but we'll stand into the gap. So increasing assessments, obviously, will drive the tax rate down. So that's good this year. The recommended budget supports total expenditures of $186.5 million. That's an increase of 2.57%. Local spending there is $89.9 million. That's an increase of just 2.05%. Again, it's an increase in the levy, but it does look like the tax rate will be going down to 6.39 per thousand. That's a reduction of 2.76%. That's the fifth year in a row that we have done that. You can check out the budget. That's at www.tompkinscountynY.gov/CTYADNIN/2019budget. So you can check it out there. We awarded Streeter Associates, Lohmeyer, the construction contract for the first phase of the passenger terminal expansion at the Tompkins Regional Airport. They did submit the lowest acceptable bid of the three that were submitted. That was $7.6 million. The project will renovate and update the airline offices. It's going to move the screening equipment behind the county area and improve the lobby area. It's also going to upgrade the facilities. So that's the first phase, obviously, and a lot of other phases. We also authorized the sale of 15 acres of airport property that's located on Warren Road to the New York State Department of Transportation. This is the first step in relocating the New York State DOT Regional Highway Maintenance. We're going to move it off of the waterfront up to Warren Road. Several Hillcrest residents in Lansing, they expressed a lot of concern about this. So much concern, actually, I voted against the sale. I personally would like to see a plan from the DOT first. They really have offered us very little. The state is not bound, apparently, by any local plan, which I don't like either, but that's the law. They do generally follow what the town planning board decides. They say they are going to do that in this case. I would like to have a more firm agreement that that is what they would do. But again, I didn't see a plan for these folks at all. They just kind of like, and to be honest, when you talk about, oh, we're going to put up DOT at the airport, I consider that at the airport. I mean, there are industrial sites that are over on the other side of the airport, on the west end, on the west side, that seem to be suitable for this as well. So I have asked the county, I did ask the Cornell owns a lot of land up there too, that maybe there are other sites that are more appropriate than this one. They are looking at that, so we will see what happens. But the state has said they will work with the people that live there on Hillcrest Road. There's about three families that are really impacted by it. Also concerning Lansing, we did authorize a spending of a little bit over $23,000 for the from the Community Housing Development Fund. This is to support the Milton Meadows project. The county's contribution is combined with $233,750 same fund, it's just an allocation from Cornell University supporting this project. Tompkins County's share does come from rebate for the housing funds, those were initially received through the Community Development Block Grant Program. We will meet again tomorrow night. One of the big issues coming forward is, we're gonna, probably, I'm assuming this is gonna pass, I'm gonna go against this again. It's, we wanted to study and co-locate the Sheriff's Department, Sheriff's Office, with the Ithaca Police Department. I don't have a big problem with that, except that the study is only gonna look at 15 sites that are within the city of Ithaca, so basically, if you're voting for this, you're voting that you support the move of the Sheriff's Department down to the city of Ithaca. You may also support that, but it would seem like that would be something you would need to vote on. Why do a study on something if you can't get that through, if you're not comfortable with that idea? Plus, it cuts out a lot of places. I mean, let's face it, the city of Ithaca doesn't have a lot of land to build on. You're gonna build, you're probably gonna build down by Walmart, or you're gonna build down in the industrial park, down behind Wegmans. I mean, if you're looking for open land, I don't know where else you would build it. There aren't any big buildings to renovate. To me, if you're looking for big buildings to renovate, you're looking like Dyson right there on 13, sits 90%. We're also looking for a place to relocate TCAT, because that's also down on the waterfront. Maybe we need a larger scope of work here as to where can we relocate things like that, and big things like that. What are the open buildings, what are the open lots, where can we do that? And I personally don't want everything to be up on Warren Road, that's not that nature either, so. Just something to consider, I think, you know, the Sheriff's Department. We rely on them a lot, just as we do as from the state police that raised the cost. So, any kind of major change, I think we should definitely be very well informed of, the public should be very well informed, and I believe that this study actually does. So, that is about it. Thank you for your time. Do you have any questions?
Any questions for Michael?
No, but I do agree they should be looking at a wider area.
Just makes sense, right?
Plan ahead, yeah.
I mean, that Dyson building sat there, and I go up there for blood drives and stuff. And ghost building. People tell me it's ugly, but I'm like, yeah, come here.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Number seven, public hearing on proposed local law number 4, 2018, a local law to make two minor amendments and corrections to official town of Lansing zoning map. And motion to open the public hearing.
So moved.
I'll second that.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
You may.
Hi.
Hi. My name is Sarah Hess. I am a local business owner and also property owner up here on Auburn Road, as well as down on Myers Road, by the way. But I just wanted to say that I'm in favor of the zoning changes for the properties in consideration. I feel like Lansing needs a downtown area. That's been in the plan. And zoning the properties in consideration appropriately, as in the changes proposed, would increase area that business can develop in areas where businesses are already developing in Lansing. And I think that's beneficial to all of us. So I'll just say that.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. You next, good.
I am. 218 Peru Hill Road. I just thought, can you go over what the zoning changes are? Because I didn't see any paperwork back there, so I'm a little lost.
It's right on the, should be paperwork about the local law, just to see if there's.
Where about?
Sorry, it's not.
Oh, it's really good.
Just to get an update, the 239 has not come back yet for the proposed zoning changes, therefore we will not be voting on this tonight. We have to wait for that and the county to weigh in. At the same time, we will not be going over to Seeker tonight because we're waiting for information from the 239, so it's just an article of information. So hopefully, I use the word hopefully now, by our next meeting we'll be able to be in a comfortable zone to address this. There were
What's up for the last of the year?
June 30 days?
Yeah, that'd give you something of our day.
It's not been 30 days, and when we reached out to the county, they assured us they could not do it since it's been only, what, 2 weeks since our last meeting. It's the right thing when you try to plan ahead and get things moving, you always try to think of the 239s, because those are things, unfortunately. You may get lucky and have them by your next meeting, but it's doubtful. So you always have to plan at least 30 more days afterwards. Anyone else have any more comments? Yes, please, come forward.
Hi, Brenda Spassky for the Boca Park Road. Not at all opposed to commercial property being developed here. I just feel obligated as a Board of Ed member to say think about our kids and their safety at that corner. I don't know if there could be restrictions to what could go in there, but I worry about kids crossing there with more traffic.
Okay, thank you. Anyone else?
Could you or somebody say in English where these two are? Is one of them between town center and the schools? And the other one between town center and where?
There's actually four pieces. Let's see, looking on the map. One of them is on the corner up here by Scoops and Sandy Schraba's property. There's also one on Trip Hammer, on the corner of Trip Hammer and Franklin. That's also Andy Schraba's property. He bought that from, I believe, the McCain's, and that is in a different zone than the other area. Let's see where the other ones are. Those are those two. And I believe the other one is Kohlenberg's property down on by Myers Road. That has not been discussed. That was originally proposed in here. Let's see what the other one was. So that's not on the discussion tonight. So I believe those are the properties in question are the ones in yellow.
But there's four properties.
There's
other properties.
Yes. Do you have any highlights? I have a highlight of each here.
I don't think the map is up here.
You may have this one.
Oh.
So Brenda, you're talking about the one across from the church, across from the school. And I agree with you 100%. You have to be very, very careful. The other ones.
Kids are going to get hit.
Kohlenberg's has been removed.
Yeah, that was not in discussion tonight.
It's not in discussion tonight.
Yeah, we have realized that.
The last meeting, we pulled it from the group that we were agreeing upon because it warranted further discussion basically for that reason.
Thank you.
And just to clarify.
Okay.
I want to clarify, basically, there's three properties that were talked about on the curve on Auburn Road. There's the Cedar Road, basically between the old town park.
Yes.
Which is basically 5 acres next to that.
Did I misspeak? It wasn't your property. My mistake. I thought it was your property there, maybe also. My mistake.
There's another thing, the house of the radiators, it's in the family term, the family center.
Correct. Thanks for that correction.
So it's two maps, it gives three of the properties next to each other, and then another property at the center. Correct.
Do you want to have this copy that's highlighted?
No,
you got a copy of it.
I have a copy of that. Thank you.
Anyone else want to make a comment tonight? You have the public hearing open. If not, would someone like move to close the public hearing?
I'll so move.
Ms. Johnson?
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Pat Terrell? Hi, Pat.
Hi.
I'll be quick.
Looks like soccer probably tonight.
Yeah, there's all the soccer kids out there. Soccer, football, cross-country, everything's running really well right now. Parks are running well, lots of reservations coming in the door, so if anybody has any questions, I'll be very brief. One other thing I would urge the board to do is be past the cleaner position, so to speak, tonight for company. That would free up some labor on me, which I greatly need at this point, so.
That's 2 hours of labor?
At least.
Well, since you're here, use as a segue, does the board have any questions for Pat pertaining to the cleaner position? Might want to hang around for the vote, please.
I have a question.
Sure.
How is the response from the dugouts? Are they functioning as expected?
The response has been great. Obviously, baseball season and softball season has passed. We do have some college kids coming in to play some events, but yeah, everyone loves them, so been very well received.
Patrick, having Cornell and Ithaca College come, is that goodness of our hearts, or do they?
They do actually pay us, yes.
It's nice.
Yeah, yes.
For the record, we talk briefly, we talk every day.
Often.
And then you're doing a fantastic job.
Thank you, sir.
Moving on to just the hiring superintendent program.
So, been all along on Great Grove. That's probably 60% complete. We've got a little over half of it full of water, pressure testing tomorrow on, so we'll hopefully here next week get the rest of the thing all tied together and stuff like that. Budget-wise on that, roll along pretty well, staying substantially under figured amount at this point, so hopefully no roadblocks along the way to kind of keep that working. Did a couple miles of pavement here the last couple days, got that squared away, been doing some storm drainage work. Odds and ends, just keep rolling along, so.
Waiting for snow?
No.
And no hurricane.
Right, so, yeah.
I noticed the pile of brush is getting bigger. Is there going to be a chip this fall, or are you waiting till spring?
Probably wait till spring, see where the budget shakes out.
Just stack it.
Had that huge pile in spring. The brush grinding is becoming a lot. but on the other hand, I mean, we've been included in the village 2 times a year, brush pickups for those folks as well. Of course, with some of the storms and things we've had, it certainly, adds to the pile, so.
We are certainly getting some commercial dumping as well.
We try to monitor that the best we can. I mean, that's, I'll be all honest. I mean, there's taxpayers in town that call and say, hey, I have so-and-so tree service coming to take a tree in my front yard. Is it all right if they bring it? I don't have an issue with that because as long as the homeowner up front knows it's being disposed of, where you get the issue is if, trying to make sure somebody's not bringing it from out of town or charging the homeowner, several hundred dollars to remove it and then dumping it,
right.
The taxpayers paying for it the same. So we do get a little, the problem is short of policing it or, locking the place off all the time. Just kind of weigh the good with the bad and just try to do the best we can.
More mulch for everybody.
Sounds of it, so. Other than that, I don't know if anybody has any questions or.
Is there still mulch available?
There's lots of them, so.
So there's still, we can request it, thanks.
Yeah. So no, there's still a good pile of that, and other than that, we're just rolling on.
Does anyone have any questions for board have already discussed the salt spreader, which is a few bit down the road, or down the page here. Do you want to do your salt spreader?
Yeah, so, I mean, I apologize, it was put on, I was trying to kind of get it. We have the quotes and stuff for it, there was a pre-winter buy available on it. I missed that window, unfortunately. We would have saved us $1,000, but, you know, I apologize, the information didn't get all the way around, but, you know, that I wasn't asking for new money, it was available within my budget. I mean, it's kind of, I went through the formality based on the procurement policy, because it's kind of a gray area. It's part and parcel of a truck, but in itself, it's a piece of equipment. So, rather than just say, whatever, I thought something simple would be simple, but it's got to know, nothing's ever simple. So that's where we're at on that. I mean, my only regret is that the taxpayer lost $100,000. So,
That's a great job, my friend, and by the way, you're definitely here with you. Thank you. You guys work so well together. I'm very, very thrilled. Other people may have their doubts, but I didn't.
Oh, yeah, there he is, yeah.
There he is.
Certainly appreciate that.
Did you go
off work?
Okay. Any other questions for our highway superintendent before we move on? Okay, thank you.
Okay, well, Milton Meadows, as you can see, on Monday we got our sidewalk approval from DOT to put in the crossing of the street, which I think is good. Guys have worked with the county on the easement for the utilities. NYSEC has agreed to the location as proposed, and we've made a couple of weeks of that back, so that'll be before you shortly. The sewer district number one, we had a working group in meeting last week. The village is preparing their plans and specifications for the location of the line. Their next step is to work with DOT on their easements, but they're, again, there was very adamant that the village is very much in support of moving along forward fast. I think we're a couple months behind what our initial time frame was, but they will make a lot of progress there as well. Actually, today I got some additional information. That's always asking for my report, but I try to wait as long as I can because something new always pops up, and then I have to give it to her at the last second, which I apologize for. But I got one more thing. I did get more information from NYSEC on our streetlights for acquiring the existing. Trying to figure out why there's a difference between the 69 lights that were built and the 40 that were in the agreement. I guess it's because the post-top lights aren't included in the LED program, so that was the difference.
But which lights are there?
There's post-top lights, either if it's BlackGen or one of the developments, they have a different type of light. So those aren't covered under this program, so that's why there's a difference. So we now have a purchase price for the LEDs. We have a $5,000 grant coming from NYSERDA. It's a smarter community coming, which we can then use to buy up the residual value of the streetlights. So when we get the check from NYSERDA, then we'll apply that towards the streetlights, and then we'll reduce our costs, operating costs, to the residents in those districts. I guess Ed's informed me that the Lansing Community Council got the $3,000 grant for their recreation program, so we're off and running with that. And
thank you.
Just put together the paperwork and get here in Lansing. So, I'll just let you know also we're waiting to hear on our grants. As you know, we did two applications for Myers Park, one under the New York State Parks, the second under the Waterfront Revitalization Program. Patrick and Gandhi had arranged a meeting with Rick and myself out on the waterfront to look at the improvements going forward, trying to get the approvals from Army Corps of Engineers and DPC. So I think we've got some good resolution on that so that they can get ready to work on it. So hopefully the grants are announced and we'll have the approvals all set for what they will do. New York State DOT Highway Facility is Mike Sigler had indicated they called up the day before they went to the county legislature and asked if they could meet. So Eric and myself met with the attorney from New York State DOT. The 15 acres was kind of a sketch on the back of an envelope type plan. They hadn't really thought more specifically about it, but trying to figure out, and we identified several issues that they probably should investigate. The least of which is you've got sewer issues. part of it's in the sewer district, part of it's not. It is in, within the water district. They do not anticipate coming to the planning board for a site plan review, at least at that time. And what they addressed to me was that they believed that the FAA would be the lead agency in a SEACR review. And actually, it'd be a NEPA review because they're a federal agency, federal funding. So they have to deaccession the land for the county, which is probably another reason that they're looking at this. Although the county did agree to sell them 15,000 acres, or excuse me, 15 acres. So I asked if, you know, the, at least the town of Lansing could be an involved agency in terms of the SEACR reviews and the NEPA reviews, but I have not heard back from them yet. I also had a conversation with the village of Cuba Heights about the sewer system. They also would like to be part of the conversation as well as the village of Lansing. I think everyone at least be part of the process, you know. And, although I know Guy, I've leaned on him a little bit about this whole concept of subdivision. If you're going to take the different parcels and merge them together, you know, they have to go through a process of that as well. So.
Yeah, there's no plan pending, so we don't know what they're going to do.
Right.
So there's not much you can say to that.
At this point, we're trying to identify what we believe the issues are, so that they can look at.
Are there any local approvals on this project? Like, do we have to, does the village or have to approve the sewer hookup, for example?
Well, the sewer hookup is approved through the town highway superintendent. The problem is that part of the parcel's in the sewer district and part of it's not. If they go with the plan as they initially proposed, there would have to be an amendment to the sewer district, which would require the town board making a change to the map, and depending on the quality or the quantity of the material that you put into it, how much of a change would be required in terms of the three-party agreement between the village of Lansing and the village of Cuba Heights and town. So again, all those are the questions we asked them, was to try to quantify how much you're going to need.
But these are things that we actually have some control over and some bargaining on the discussion.
Depends on who you ask. Next, I'll just go through some of the planning board projects. The day that we had the meeting down at Myers Park with the Army Corps and DEC, they decided to go next door and meet with Finger Lakes Marine, so I tagged along, so that we could hopefully get all the information consistent between the different vendors and meetings. So we also had a follow-up site plan meeting with John Anderson, the engineer. And then just recently on Monday, we also followed up with the Department of Health on the issues in terms of the septic system, the water system improvements. So I'm trying to draft up some resolutions now, which I'm sure wait until Guy gets back. This pile of work that's been settled in the last week, hopefully we'll throw a few more things out.
I've got a quick question on that. I know there's been some dispute over stuff that has been approved, stuff that may have been built without approval. And is that getting sorted out through this process?
Well, what we're doing at this point is trying to put everything on the map so that we can document where it is today. Mm-hmm. There's two issues. One is doing work without a permit. Some information went around to some people. The marina then counted their view of things. You know, there were some existing things there that were approved, not things that were brand new. And there's some gray area between both.
I know, and I'm hoping that we can sort some of that gray area out through this process so that we can have it as a settled issue at this point onward.
That's the intent, is to try to get everybody on the same page so that at least we know today we're here. That's the ultimate goal. The zoning map, you've already discussed tonight. Land use ordinance, the planning board on Monday, the 24th, is going to have a 5:00 time to get together and look at input on the standard zoning map. You know, at this point, we've got some concepts that were developed through the comprehensive planning process and started to try to take a look at how that would wash out in terms of a zoning map. So, planning board first will take a crack at taking a look at what's there at this point and find to tweak things a little bit from time to time. Massage the map a little bit further before we get into actual public interaction and public presentations and such.
Is it 5:00?
5:00. And then there'll be a planning board meeting at 6:30 that same night. Subcommittee has been meeting. We've had a lot of input in terms of definitions. I think we've got a working draft at this point. We'll try try to circulate that. It's better going around the planning board members. I think that's worked out quite well. We've got a few late additions just recently, so we'll try to add some more of those things. Dutch Harvest Farm had a sketch plan review in the September 10th meeting, looking for the complete stormwater package. That will go through the process when that gets submitted. On the 24th, during the planning board meeting, NextAmp is doing a sketch plan review for a solar farm at 339 Jerry Smith Road. So again, it's a rather large plan. They're looking for some input from the planning board as to some of the impacts that they'd like to see addressed as part of the final plan. They also would be doing a stormwater plan as well.
Mike?
Yes?
I'm sorry. The Dutch Harvest Farm is 1487 Ridge Road. Can you give me an idea how far out it is?
You know where Sharon Bowman's new house is?
No.
Okay. You know where the power plant is?
Of course.
Okay. Back up about three parcels.
On which side? Right or left?
On the same side as the power plant.
Okay.
It was a subdivision there probably 4 years ago, three years ago. Turned that farm into four parcels. This is one of those parcels.
Was Ann Sheldon?
Ann Sheldon, yes.
Do you recall?
Oh.
That's where the land was divided so that the Bowmans could build on it. I think it was Putnam's also in there.
Putnam's and Bowman's, and they reconfigured.
Okay.
And Kevin Putnam also built next to Barry towards the back, and then Doug and Sharon in front. Then you have the other parcels there.
We used to run that.
There you go. Now we've gone full circle. Now you know where you are, right?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Thank you. I couldn't. Thanks.
So we've had some, the neighbors came and had some interesting comments. I think, you know, again, we're looking to try to get the stormwater analysis done. They're proposing to put a fairly good sized pond on the site with a rather large pond as an event for weddings and things of that nature. So, again, it's permitted, so we're trying to go through the site plan review process.
Oh, it's a beautiful place to have.
It's a great location.
Great location.
The more recent things that have just submitted, Old Orchard Road, there's a previously developed area with a shared driveway or drive a shared road. So I'm just starting to get into that project. I'm trying to look at that, creating a 4-acre parcel. And then 41 Dutch Mill, which is an addition to an existing manufacturing facility. It's in the PDA. I know when we did Village Solar, that was changing the density. This is just a site plan approval, so we're just going for the planning board. We have to go back to the PDA for the addition.
It depends on the way it's written. It's going to depend on whether it triggers one of four or five different standards under the PDA. If it's a major change, it may have to be an amendment to that. It's just a minor change, then it may not even need site plan review. Depends exactly what it is.
It's just a small addition to the existing buildings. I think it's like a 20% increase in the size of the building.
There's actually something in the PDA law that covers that, so we'd have to look it up. Send me the plan and I'll throw you an opinion.
Well, they're working on finalizing the plan, okay. So once I get it, we'll get it over. So that's what I have.
Questions for Michael? Engineer report, there is none for Dave Eric. That does not mean Dave's not working. He is. A lot of different things. They just haven't come to fruition yet. It was on to add a new report. I do see County here. I guess they're going to be gearing up. Brings us to the privilege of the floor. Mike, I'm going to ask you to double duty.
Connie wants to say something.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't say that.
That's okay.
Hold that thought.
I don't have to speak.
I'm sorry.
I don't really have much to report, but you should have all received something from Scott Doyle regarding farmland grants, similar to
what we did.
Yes.
And we're thinking of expanding because we have a piece of property that we bought after we did it.
Right. Yeah. Right. So we had a preliminary meeting with Steve Pat last week, he's thinking of doing a couple of things. He wants to transition maybe into just raising the cows. And he's also...
You mean raising heifers?
Huh?
Raising heifers?
Yes. And he's also in partners with a farm in Cuba County. And his partner, she's getting ready to retire, so...
Steve Fett is our neighbor.
Yeah. Your name, yes. So, he knows. So, anyways, we met with him. We had a preliminary meeting with Scott Doyle, and Cooperative Extension, Deb Teeter was there, and another girl, and I have her card, and I can't remember what her name is, but she's new. Anyways, this may be coming before the board at some point in time, because the county cannot, they don't, Scott Doyle feasibly does not have the time to do any more of these, because he has to monitor all the ones that we have in the county now. So they may be asking the town to take this project on, but you would get, and there may be some financial stuff needed from the town, but you would get back your money once the grant is granted.
That's right.
And so I said that Andra is very familiar with all of this, so hopefully she can help educate the rest of the board as to what we're trying to do. So like I said, it's all very preliminary at this point in time, but it's really good to see a dairy farmer that's interested in getting into this program, because we're losing our dairy farms and we need to protect them. So more to come on that, but I just wanted to give you a heads up, and hopefully you guys can have a meeting and kind of talk about what the process would be if we do this.
Great.
So, okay?
Okay.
And we haven't had any ag meetings all summer because of, well, it's summer. And they're all busy. So we're planning a meeting on October 1st, tentatively. And we'll get the message out there and let everybody know, but...
What day of the week is that?
Monday.
It's on a Monday.
It's on Monday.
So, we'll, if it happens, but I really have to check with the farmers and Steve in the middle of chopping and all that.
Sure.
It's not feasible, so we may not do that until November, but I just want to make you aware of of Steve Pat's proposal, so.
Great.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Patty.
I'm going to just quickly comment on that proposal. You can sit back. You don't have to stand.
Thanks.
I can't remember how many years ago, but it's been years since we decided to sell the development rights of our land and made our farm a farm forever. And so we can farm it right now. My son and daughter-in-law are farming it. They can actually sell it, but only as a farm. They cannot develop any of the land that was put into that. So it's like a farm trust. It was one of the best things we ever, ever did. It gave us some money, and the grant was nice, but the money did come out, such as taxes, but also to pay for the different people who had to prepare everything. I mean, there was a gigantic survey, but that came out of the grant that we were given. So when you see the whole total grant, we didn't get all of that money. Still, it made it possible for us to transfer the farm to our son Chandler and his wife Aziza. It would have not been possible because our farm was valued, and this is 12 years ago, about $3 million. And now it's more. But anyway, it made it possible for them to for us to transfer it to them. And they didn't have to take out a gigantic loan of $3 million. We didn't, that's not what we got, but anyway. It's a wonderful program. I'm very sad that more farmers don't do it. But I think farmers, especially if you have a lot of land on your on a road, like we do, Lansing Hill Road, you always think, oh good, I don't have any money this year, I'm gonna sell off a lot. You know, and so then it ends up all along the road, house. Now we can't do this ever again, Did we ever do it? No, we've never done that. Thanks be to God, we didn't need the money at the time. But that's what it is, you sell your development rights. We still own the farm. And the four of us, my husband and I, Chandler and Aziza. But if we sell, it has to be a farm. And I think it's just a fabulous way to preserve the land. And if anybody's ever been to my house, I do have one of the better views in the whole town, except we're not on the lake. But I have a fabulous view of about a third of Cayuga Lake, including Cornell and Ithaca College. Fabulous view. And it'll stay that way. Nobody could ever, ever develop it. And so I just feel very strongly, it's a fabulous program. I'll talk to anybody about it. And I'm extremely happy Connie told me that our neighbor is considering it.
Can I ask you something?
Sure.
It sounds like a good idea, and I'm glad it worked out. I just wonder, who would buy this right?
Who buy the right? Who bought the rights?
Yeah.
The town.
The town did?
Yeah, but the town got the money from the state. It didn't cost the town anything. It's a state grant. It's a way for the state of New York to preserve farmland. That's the whole purpose of it. That forever, who knows what forever means, this land stays farmland. And it doesn't have to be a dairy farm, but it has to be a farm. And the next person that owns it in the year, I don't know, 2080, let's say, if it's not a relative of ours, they could farm it. And they could put cattle on it. They can farm it. They don't have to milk cows like we do. And they don't have to crop it like we do. But it has to be a farm. And I think that's just fabulous.
Okay. There's nothing else to discuss about that. Limit to 20 minutes at the maximum of 3 minutes per speaker. I have one written down here, and after that gentleman speaks for a maximum up to a maximum of 3 minutes, we can, I'll ask other people who have perhaps come in late or who are now inspired to come forward to do so. So we have Stephen Smith.
Yeah, mine's real brief. It's about the gun club and supporting, you know, I think the board has been pretty supportive of the situation. But this picture shows the lake. As we all know, the Lansing is, you know, it's even on the trucks. The lake is right along the town, but right over here is the gun club. So it isn't very far to the lake, is my point. And, you know, I think that situation needs to be dealt with. In 1950, when the salt mine, you know, when the International Salt gave some of their employees the land so they could start a sportsman club, I don't think they knew what they were, you know, in 1950, nobody knew anything about that. And obviously, things have changed since then, and, you know, and now the EPA's addressed it, and you know, I hope the town supports that whole situation. Let's deal with it and try to protect, do our job to protect the lake. So that's my thing. So there's the lake, and it's amazing how close it is.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Does anyone else want to take advantage of the privilege of the floor? Okay, we'll close that door. What I'd like to do is move ahead our discussion on the Lansing Rod and Gun Club, since there are people here. I don't want you to stay, but we have a few more things to discuss pertaining to that. So we do have some brief information here as far as what is the latest status. And what that is, as you know, there is a stop work order on that. And right now, and I'll let Guy correct me if I misspeak, because I don't want to jeopardize the town by giving misinformation. But it's my understanding that a stormwater protection plan now is in the works to address that concern. Am I correct?
That's my understanding.
Okay. Once we find out what that plan is and it is implemented, then we will move forward with further discussion. To your point, Steve, I'm also a commissioner for Bolton Point. I've asked them to test water for lead, not from our own testing group, but from a credible industry that does that, a company that does that. And using as a segue, I would also like to use that same company to to test the lead and at the Ludlowville Falls and at the water also there in Ludlowville. That's something I think that the town can do now to see what the levels are there and to see if our citizens are in danger. So I move forward on two things. One from Bold Point, which they have agreed on to test their water, to make sure that the lead's not coming in there. More importantly, for Ludlowville and the creek there, to make sure that what the levels are there. That's what we can do as a town for right now. The rest of the stuff that we'll be talking about will be sheer speculation. I don't know what their plan is officially, if they do have a plan. I don't know what the conversation was with EPA. If they've agreed on something, they haven't. I would not have those conversations. And I would not speculate, because I'm representing the town. Anything I do here would jeopardize the town, even though as a private citizen, I may have a certain view, but in all fairness, I would think it'd be irresponsible for any board member to express their personal views, because we have such a delicate issue right now. You want to add anything to this, Guy? I know you've been away for a week.
Yeah, you know, it was a great week off. But no, I mean, I agree that we don't know what the plan is. It's possible something could come before the ZBA or the planning board or this board. So if you don't stay neutral, if you make statements, if you get involved, you will end up being recused either by wise action, by consulting an ethics board, or by a court one way or the other. You can harm what the position of the town is. So I just encourage everyone to just sort of let the process flow and speak as a group, as a unit, as a municipality to EPA and DEC.
I would just like to say that checking the sediment would be better than checking the water in Ludlowville Creek. That's where you're more likely to find lead at this point.
Especially in the falls area.
Joe, I can't hear you. What did you say?
Check the sediment rather than checking the water. That's where you're more likely to find it.
I will reach out to these people when I get their proper information to see what testing needs to be done. I'm open-minded to any testing as far as that goes. All this information is great information. I thank you for sending the board members websites to look at and data and studies, but I'm not being rude by not responding. I'm just saying thank you for the information. I read it, I absorb it. But I'm not going to comment on it, because anything that can be foiled could be looked at as that a certain position. So I'm saying to people that if they want to share information with me like you did right now, which is good, we move forward in a very methodical, calm manner. Yes, Steve?
I think that if you wanted to know how, in general, what the town feels about it, there was 100, that I emphasize this, it was 140 people, 100 people signed a petition almost immediately objecting to the 1950 practices of that gun club. So, you know, if you think that you're concerned, well, is there any support out there? I think it's there. I was kind of nervous when she started petitioning and said, I hope this works. And she got it instantly. I was really surprised, you know. So if you're concerned about any support in Ludlowville or the town in general for trying to deal with the situation, I think it's there, so.
Anyone else want to make a comment before we move on?
I just want to ask her a quick clarification. When, at your last meeting, when you were talking about testing Ludlowville, it was all theoretical at that point, you were talking about the falls as part of that. Is that part of what you're going to ask them to do?
Any other comments, questions? Yes, ma'am.
So there's a stormwater assessment in the works right now?
They call it a SWIP, Stormwater Prevention Plan.
And did the Gun Club decide to do that on their own, or is someone forcing them to do that?
The stop order was put in place because the Gun Club allowed Lynn to go on and to roll the area. It takes a roller, which measures exactly how big this area is. It was over 1 acre of disturbance. Therefore, it's over 1 acre of disturbance. So I believe it was close to 2 acres. But once again, I don't want to speculate without exact information. So I'm hesitant to to move forward on that subject. So it was over 1 acre, which was triggered a stop order.
Right.
And that means nothing happens until they come up with their stormwater prevention plan.
Okay, so it's not really in the works. It's just they either have to do that.
My understanding is they're working on it now.
They are.
And then we'll go forward when we have the stormwater prevention plan. And we'll see where that goes.
And we'll put it on the town agenda so that.
As soon as we can share information, we'll put it on the website. As soon as we can share accurate information. Anyone else? Okay. I am on clerk events the tentative 2018 town of Lansing budget.
This is really just a formality. All of you have already received this yesterday in your mailboxes. So it's just a formality that I present this to the tentative 2019 town of Lansing budget. Thank you.
Thank you. So, item number 15. Motion approving hiring superintendent purchasing replacement salt spreader.
I move it.
I'll second.
Pause right in on that one. I think we got a little more rental here, Cricket.
Just like 2 weeks ago, that's about $1,000 right there. Yeah.
I would put that under teachable moment. And part of it, I'll take the blame for it, but I should have probably insisted that you be there. So, having said that, we do have a motion from one of you, from Doug, and a second from
Katrina.
Okay, you spoke first.
Okay.
Any further?
You can't hear from us down here.
Any further discussion? Ms. Munson?
All in favor?
Yes.
Aye.
Okay. Item number 16, resolution approving standard of pay reporting of elected and appointed officials.
I'll move that.
You want a second, Katrina?
Sure.
Okay, since you looked this over, right?
Yes.
Okay. Any further discussion? Ms. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Bigboy?
Yes.
Doug Bate?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Yes. Next is resolution item 17, authorizing acceptance of bid and issuance of notice of award to R.B. Robinson Contracting Incorporated for consolidated water district extension directional drilling contract.
I'll move it.
Okay. Any discussion?
I'm just curious why the bid is so vastly different.
I can only tell you what we expected for, but
they're about double. One of them is double the other.
Well, I can pretty much tell you it's a busy time of season, so the guy that bid double the price was banking on, and the only bidder that might take it for that money, he'd be here tomorrow. So I'm just saying. Doug, tell you how the business works. You're busy, but for the right price, you'll be there tomorrow.
Absolutely.
I think for me. You could put in the budget pretty close to that $43,000, wasn't it?
Yep. No, yeah, so actually, I just say, I mean, it worked out fair. I mean, you're probably looking at 37, 38, so we're paying a little bit of a premium there. But we picked up a little extra scope there, you know. So I was happy with the price of 43. Fits well within the realm of the budget.
Good. Any further discussion? Mrs. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Bakewood?
Yes.
Doug Day?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Edward Levine?
Yes. Item 18, resolution approving hiring of general building cleaning contract.
I move it.
I second it.
Any further discussion? One comment I will make is that we'll start the process again, probably November. If anything, this gives us a good idea of these people's abilities and if they fit what we need them to do. No other comments, Mrs. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Binkelwitz?
Yes.
Doug Day?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Edward Lee?
Yes. Item 20, resolution approving and authorizing execution of final proposed form of deed, stormwater management agreement. Oh, my goodness, you were, and I can't get my body, can I? I'm not that clever, I think I was gonna have a purpose. Resolution hiring Matt Dietrich as a part-time school crossing guard.
I'll move it.
That was a tough, okay.
We had a co-motion, just the last second.
I'll second it.
Katrina moves it.
We need a crossing guard.
This is, I've done this myself, this is a town road. And the buses are on one side, the cars are close to the school, we need a crossing guard for this, because it's our responsibility. Thank you, Matt Dietrich, for stepping forward. Ironically, what happened, he always does, someone steps forward, and all the people across, we're not even more cool people, which is wonderful. In case, God forbid, he gets sick, or he takes vacation day. So we have, and also, Charmaine has done this, Patrick has done this, Corey's done this, Sue Munson was doing this, with a team effort to found somebody on a more reliable basis. So having said that, Mrs. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Binkelwitz?
Yes.
Doug Day?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Edward Lee?
Yes. Now, number 20, resolution approving and authorizing execution of final proposed form of deed, stormwater management agreements, and utility easements and easement locations for Milton Meadows project. This was the one we talked about earlier with Michael, who is the easements over, who is nice and comfortable with them, amongst others. I'll move it.
I'll second it.
Any further discussion? Mrs. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Binkelwitz?
Yes.
Doug Day?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Edward Lee?
Yes. 21, approve audit and budget modifications.
Move that one.
I'll second it.
Any further discussion? I'll ask one comment, by the way, for asking those questions in advance. It's a good system now. I appreciate you making time for your busy schedule. I know you're stretched for time as we are. I appreciate that, because that way we get accurate information, and you get information you're comfortable with.
I want to have the information in advance. I was here at 10 o'clock last night, we were doing those, so. Not just so that we have time to look over and have a good discussion so that I understand what I'm saying. Thank you. And thank you, staff, for answering those questions really promptly.
Having said that, no further discussions. Mrs. Munson?
Andrew Benson?
Yes.
Katrina Binkelwitz?
Yes.
Doug Day?
Yes.
Joseph Whitmore?
Yes.
Edward Lee?
Reports.
Okay. I've been out of commission for a little bit. I know we're not supposed to get too personal, but I'm just saying, everybody in the town, and there's lots of you who are pulling for me because I really got close to not making it, and I'm very, very, very grateful. Whether you know about what happened or not, doesn't make any difference. I am so grateful that I'm here. And I haven't been able to at any of my meetings. I was in the hospital. But I'm really, really getting better. And I'm just so happy. So I will go to my library meetings, go to my Lansing Youth Services meetings, and I would love to go to the ad meeting, but I have a doctor's appointment that time.
Well, it may not happen anyways.
Yeah, exactly. So kind of let me know, and we'll see what happens. And also, Connie, I'd like to offer in the future, because there's not a whole lot of us, if they would like to have the ag meeting in my house. In fact, if you have it, I'll check again my schedule. I can't drive for another 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. So I would not mind having the meeting up at my house. So.
Okay. We can move forward again.
Yeah. It may be, my doctor's appointment may be late afternoon, so.
Like I said, we may have to wait till November.
Just let me know. Yeah, okay. I'd sort of like to get involved again, because okay. Things are starting to calm down health-wise for our whole family.
Good.
So,
good.
I'd like to do that.
Okay. Joe?
favor to have me here, here too. So I speak for more than just myself. One of the items that was on the agenda was the cable service franchise agreements. There's a real problem right now because the fees are based on cable service and the lines are getting used more and more for internet and phone. And so the locales are getting less and less revenue from the cable companies, even though their revenues are up. There's been real attempts throughout Tompkins County to renegotiate Spectrum and really stonewall it. And they've not been really community partners on this. And so I'm just reporting the standing that comes from many municipalities who are trying to push Spectrum to talk about that contract and how it's changing. The other thing that was up was TCOG voted to recommend suspension of the tax assessment boards. I know I talked with you, Ed, you were very much in favor of that, it was continuing. If you look over the history of them, there's been a dramatic drop in the number of people who participated. For example, in 2003, we actually had 46 people participate. This year we had 3. And we were one of the higher of the community, so many of them had nobody participate at all. And the county takes about 2 weeks of staff time to prep for these, and the report was about half the time they overruled what the community assessment board said anyway. So what they're doing is they're going to not do it for next year, see how that goes, reassess, and see what they're going to do for the following year. So this is just a one-year trial to see how it goes and to see how it goes smoothly or not. The Ithaca Tompkins Transportation Council was mostly talking about adjustments to the TIP program, both changes to the state key performance targets that are in place. Feds keep telling us to adjust and make new adjustments for the standards standard program project. They have a basic book of how we do things, and we keep adding new things and more basically safety features that are new things that we have to look at when looking at highway projects and stuff. And they also did some line item changes to some of the projects that are in the works right now. Cuba Lake Watershed Organization. We had a wonderful cruise where a bunch of municipalities around the lake got together and went out on the lake and talked about lake issues a little bit and really socialized. I think it was very nice to donate some wine for that cruise. And I'm sorry you didn't make it, Ed. I think you had an allocation for the
budget,
wasn't it?
Yeah.
Planning board, as Mike said, we're working on new definitions. I've been working with Mike pretty heavily on some of those. Unfortunately, I'm not going to make it to Monday's meeting, so I'm hoping some of the other board members can, because I think it's really important that the board be a part of that discussion. And I know we have been up to now, and I think that's been a good addition. So those are my reports.
Okay, Doug.
I'll be at the meeting too.
Thank you.
Other than that, I have nothing to report.
Katrina?
As an aside from my schoolwork, there is a new initiative in the county called Be the One. I don't know if you've seen any t-shirts that say that or black bracelets that say that, but it has to do with really emphasizing the fact that all children, not just children, but senior citizens, people with handicaps, everybody needs to have somebody paying attention, being friendly, helping out. So it's just a loving neighbor, just reach your hand out and help anybody, you know, smile, do something nice. It's a nice initiative, and it's going to be presented to schools and at faith organizations, and it's, I think, something we can all get behind. So I'll fill you in as it goes forward.
Okay. So, a couple things going on. Besides the usual balls in the air, will be the rod and gun, or vote for consolidated water district number 3 week here next week, 7 in the morning to 7 at night. We'll be here on September 26th. Deb Munson offered to send out notices to everyone, which she did, and I appreciate that. And once again, it's up to those people that propose district to see if they want to have water or not. And 51% will take it, right? I use that as a segue to now we have a new water district developing, site number 5. This might be actually number 6, or it might be an extension of Lansing Station Road. Met with Rob Carpenter and Jim Ronick, and they put a petition together, and it looks to be about $1,550, and 49 out of 50 people say yes. And hopefully the Water and Sewer Advisory Board will push this forward, and we'll have a discussion maybe August 3rd at our meeting. October 3rd at our meeting. October 3rd. Yeah, really. Yeah, hopefully we'll get 2021. At our October 3rd meeting, hopefully we'll have some discussion then. As you know, the Water and Sewer Advisory Board recommends at least 75%, once you canvass the area, at least 75% say yes before you come to the town board and allocate the map plan report. The interesting thing about this district is that you have a railroad, and the railroad will not look at this until they pay a fee of $2,500. And that fee won't come about until the district is formed. So they will have to go under the railroad. What happens after that, I don't know, but there's two things that are driving this. One is that the lake has been lowered, and for some of the people, they have a very shallow, quote unquote, well. And the other part is that people are concerned about the algae bloom. Because you're in very shallow water, you don't have the filtration.
Right.
There's some dynamics involved with this, and that's a larger number. Will the comptroller accept it or not? I don't know. That may be phase 6 or multiple phases we have to go through. So that will be coming on our table in October, perhaps 3rd, or perhaps on the 17th. The thing with the IDA, we've mentioned briefly about the STM Landscaping, which is Scott Morgan's project, which is right next to Bounce Around, or Jump Around Inflatable, as you say. That one is like the chicken and the egg. I put that on your email to sensitize you that it may need board approval, but he may have to apply first, so you know that it is an industrial development area. Just like the market is, just like the old pit stop building is, that whole area is an industrial development area. But I think this is the first one we've ever had to do. Maybe Andy can. Did we have to do one when you put the market together? No.
You're talking about the town's incentive zone.
Yeah.
The town's incentive zone has never been used before the IDA.
Yeah, this is why I'm talking to Heather McDaniel. This would be the IDA. And then we'll see where that goes. Perhaps Mr. Morgan, but we had a conversation with Mr. Morgan. Well, I have to fill out the application first. If it comes onto our table, at least we'll understand what that's about. We'll have more information. This is just priming the what else? Nothing that isn't in, I want to talk about tonight because everything else is still in developing stages. The budget, all the different departments have worked hard on that. It's moving the process forward. Now we're in the 10th budget stage. We'll have discussions about that. There have been some great emails going back and forth. I appreciate that. To give us enough time to give discussions, definitions, where this is coming from. I look forward to anybody's suggestions and input to see where we're going with this. It looks like the way it stands now, that even we had to increase some of the drainage district's contributions, because those are going to be stormwater things we're going to have to address down the road, and you don't want to have the if I wanted your brain, I'd have to do them all in one evening. So that is something that's come on the plate. We also had to increase the rates a bit, I think, with the sewer, at least to increase the revenue. And having said that, that's only because of more and more development. Put $12,000 in the sewer budget so we can start doing the I&I mitigation of the Warren Road. That, you'll hear more about I&I. This is inflow, infill, and infiltration. And what this is that you have sewer pipe, and you have your product that goes through it. And this is the language they speak. The product goes through it. What we've done on the new sewer, District Number One, is we're going to have a meter that's going to measure that. So as it goes from the hopefully future developments, from the town of Lansing pipe into the village of Lansing pipe, there'll be a meter there, because that district is only allowed 33,050 gallons a day. What happens, though, is that in the older systems, you have this inflow of a heavy rain. It could be a root growing into it, it could be a low manhole cover, it could be a crack, it could be whatever, and what happens is the water pours in to those pipes, goes into the sewer system, and it has to be addressed. And the DEC watches that, because when the spikes happen, they usually allow you 1 month. And when more spikes happen, they get very concerned about that, and they ask, will you address it? And if you don't address it, they say, we will address it, and here's how many months you have, and you're going to have to pay for it. So our systems are fairly new. Well, what do we have? Cherry Grove, I think, and Warrenville districts, and this new one. But the older systems are a bit of a struggle. John will attest that in the village, they had to basically keep finding more INI, do more sewer units. As you, and the other thing is that this sewer treatment plant in the village of Cuga Heights only has so much capacity. So as we keep trying to get tighter and tighter, we're going to be more and more concerned about the INI. The thing also, though, which is the good news, is that a lot of the new devices, whether it be shower heads or toilets, don't use as much as before. And what used to be in the old days is that you would say, okay, 324 gallons per day is what you'll use on your unit. Now, it's not that now, but we're in the process of finding out what that new number is for people. So, if you look at the whole water system with what I call the Big Six, which are the six different municipalities that formed out the sewer district way back when, and all the different problems they have been looking at, it looks like this is all coming at once now, and they're going to have to address them. And it's not that they haven't been willing to address them. And it could be the fact that the spirit of cooperation is at an all-time high, according to other members like John, who's been around for a while. But it's like, how can we as a town of Lansing help? I think we're about 5% of the whole district. Hopefully it'll be a little more soon. But 5% of the whole district. But so you're listening, plus you're also listening at the Ithaca sewer treatment plant, so there's different dynamics going on here. So stay tuned, more to more products will be flowing. Okay. So having said that, that's for your benefit. Having said that, I think that's all I have here from my report. Guy, do you have anything besides the fishing and motor pulling? You told me that voted.
Well, yeah, we did rescue a couple stranded out on 25-mile-an-hour waves on a bad day up there. But other than that, it was a really nice week. So back and most everything that had to get done was done. So we'll see what happens in 2 weeks.
Good. One thing I'm going to mention about Deb, you can talk if you like, but Deb Munson has a broken foot, and she has a scooter, and she just chugs along, and she keeps going. And I wouldn't say last man standing, I would say definitely the last person standing. So thank you for all your hard work as you keep chugging along, literally. The only thing I'd ask is to put a bell on that thing, because you almost ran me over today.
That was
on purpose. It was. As far as the budget goes, we'll start throwing emails back and forth. We've got some good discussion. I don't know if you want to discuss some of that tonight. Some board members have discussed it for the first time. You might want to digest it. You know, you have those in the projection sheets. Or I don't know if there's anything for executive session. We can adjourn and call it an evening.
I request that we adjourn and call it an evening.
I hope you say.
I second.
Okay.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.